Hey folks, Sirdar here, and in this episode of Dev with Sirdar, we're going to take a first look at the announced changes in NumPy 2.0. Now, if you use Python and you work with data, you know NumPy. It's one of the top 20 most widely downloaded packages for Python, and one of the first ones people learn when doing data science work with Python in any form. And now it's headed towards a major point revision from 1.x to 2.0. So in this video, we're going to quickly run down what's new, what's being changed, and how to cope with it. The first big thing that's new in NumPy 2 is a long overdue cleanup of the Python API for NumPy. And what this means is the way things are namespaced in the Python NumPy module is getting cleaned up drastically. It'll become much easier to find things and to write NumPy code overall. See, NumPy's Python interface just kind of grew over the years, and as a result, it's become quite a sprawl. It isn't always clear what's public or what's private, and a lot of things aren't very clearly named. Third-party libraries that use NumPy often only implement a small part of NumPy because of the cost involved of tracking all this stuff. So it's become hard to learn about, hard to add to, and hard to maintain. Now with NumPy 2, about 100 objects in the main namespace, the NumPy or NP namespace as it's often abbreviated, are being renamed, combined with other functions, or deprecated and removed entirely. Here's a simple for instance. There's historically been three ways to refer to infinity in NumPy. np.inf with an uppercase I, np.infinity also with an uppercase I, and np.infT. Now with NumPy 2, you just get np.inf. Simple, unambiguous, easy to type and remember, and also easy to fix. Now, how will this cleanup affect most NumPy programs? The short answer is it shouldn't, if your programs are already relatively clean and idiomatic. In other words, most of the things that are being cleaned up are things that shouldn't be in common use anyway. Here's an example. I have some code here that I've taken from the matplotlib documentation. This is a favorite demo for NumPy, the Mandelbrot set. So I run it right now in the most recent production release of NumPy, and of course it runs fine. I don't yet have a version of NumPy 2 that I can test against, but I do have documentation for what's being changed. And if I consult that documentation, I can see all the uses of everything in the top-level NP namespace I have here are not going to change at all. The only thing that comes even remotely close to that is this type, np.complex64. This is recommended as a replacement for something that's being deprecated. So this code's pretty much NumPy 2 ready. One thing you want to do now, if you can help it, and this is just good standard practice, remove any global imports from NumPy. For instance, if you have from NumPy import star. Another thing to remove is imports from private modules like numpy.core. The first of these, the star import, that's bad practice anyway. And the second is to be avoided since the core namespace is meant for internal use only. So those are two things you can jump on right now if you haven't done it so far. Another key change that's going to be taking place is low level, the NumPy C API. So any C++ or C code or Python code that you're writing that talks directly to NumPy's APIs will have to be recompiled to work properly once version 2 drops. The other question you're likely to ask is, what actual new features are being rolled out with NumPy 2? The short answer is, at first, not a whole lot. And that's probably because the first few releases are just going to be about getting over the hump of cleaning up the namespace, getting everybody on board with those changes. But there are a couple of things that look very interesting. One of them is improved CPU optimization tracking. And this is something NumPy tries to use when functions are optimized for certain CPUs with certain instruction sets. And what this new feature does is it lets you figure out which CPU targets are available for what functions as a debugging measure. And this allows you to get more insight into how things are being optimized for faster instruction sets. Another thing that's available right now, and what you don't have to wait around on NumPy 2.4 actually, is support for Cython 3. You can write modules in Cython, which is basically type-decorated Python, compile them into C extension modules, and have them work natively with NumPy for an additional speed boost. I've actually got another video that you can check out separately that goes into this in more detail, but see my note in the description. But again, you can use Cython 3 with NumPy 1.26 or higher right now. So what's next if you're interested in trying out NumPy 2? Well, for now, I'd say sit tight and wait until official binaries are available. I'm going to be all over that once they drop. The full release for NumPy 2 should not be out until the end of 2023. But any code you're working on right now, go ahead and start making a distinct version of it for NumPy 2 support, because there ought to be enough internal and external changes to warrant a separate version. And again, when NumPy 2 does drop, we'll be back here to take a closer look. So that's it for this episode. If you liked it, leave a comment below. And don't forget to follow Dev with Sirdar and InfoWorld on Facebook, YouTube, and InfoWorld.com.